let's talk about all things Doctor Who. Why do you love Doctor Who?
Why do I love Doctor Who? I think because I got it from a very early age. Mm-hmm. Brain of Morbius. And I've been afraid of it. I've been terrified of it. And so because I was terrified of it, and I willed myself to get up the bravery to watch it, and then I was hooked. It kind of, when the ending of Brain of Morbius came and the Doctor actually won, it really did something for me. It changed something in me. It was a safe scare. I think I was, the safest of childhoods, as people who've read my novel Chalk may have realised. And so it really, the safe scare was really useful for me, really changed something in me. And from then on, I was an obsessive. Mm-hmm. And I just built my own writing out of that. I centred the writing I started to do a few years later, actually, by about 1980-81, around this thing that was mine. I've never looked back from there. It's kind of always been, it's been the golden thread at the heart of the career, you know.
You mentioned how The Brain of Morbius was actually the story that kind of hooked you into Doctor Who. Would you say Tom Baker is your Doctor?
Basically, he was always there in childhood. He was right at the centre of pop culture. And so it didn't, that aspect, I only realised that when Peter Davison came along and not as many people liked him, suddenly that was mine. He was my Doctor because not so many people liked him. Later, Sylvester McCoy very much became my Doctor as well. And I also feel tremendously about Capaldi. I mean, you know, he's my Doctor as I got to this age. But I love what they're doing now. So all in all, can I offer four Doctors to you as my Doctor there?
I mean, the thing is with the actors who play the Doctor is that every single person brings something new to that role. You've worked on this programme now. You're not just a fan. You've actually worked and you've written episodes of this programme. Tell me about your first experience of writing Doctor Who.
My first experience of writing it professionally was comic strips 25 years ago. And my first experience of writing TV came about when Russell called me up. And because there had been Scream of the Shulker, the animated show with Richard E. Grant, a year or so before, Russell called me up and told me really early on that there wasn't going to be any more of that. And he told me, I think, before anybody else knew, because my bosses kept on thinking there'd be a sequel for the longest time. And I was like, when he told me there wasn't going to be any more of that, he said, because we're bringing back Doctor Who, and if you're not careful, well, you never know. And he left it at that, dot, dot, dot. And I spent weeks thinking, wow, what do I have to do? And I was working on Casualty at the time, and I'd written lots and lots of Casualty episodes. And Mal Young, who was the head honcho of Casualty, was a big part of the return of Doctor Who. His name doesn't get spoken of very often in the history now, because I think he got out fairly quickly. He left the BBC shortly thereafter. But he was kind of, I think maybe he's instrumental in bringing it back and also in me being part of it. Mm. And so, you know, that was how I got into it. Russell finally gave me the call. We'd become aware, the little group of writers who, you know, had risen up during the 15 years between the old show and the new, that we were getting gigs, that Rob Shearman had gotten the call, that Mark Gatiss had gotten the call. And Moffat kept saying, well, I don't know, I might be busy. I mean, he was kind of getting all gruff about it, thinking, well, I should have gotten the call by now.
What responsibility as well, like, you know, writing an episode of Doctor Who, you will kind of be remembered for your episodes of Doctor Who for years to come. People will look back and see your episodes. Let's talk about the tweet along. Two of your episodes, Human Nature and Family of Blood, are going to be watched globally. Tell me more about that.
Well, it's exciting. I've been enjoying the tweet-alongs a lot so far. I love the fact that it's sort of a whole new art form that, you know, me and Gaiman have been talking a bit about this in tweets. We've been comparing notes as to how you handle it, because it comes at you very fast. It's a live art form. So basically, I've got about two sets of 45 minutes to entertain, to provide information, to chuck stuff at people. I haven't got an unlimited budget even, because there are only, 60 tweets allowed in an hour? Mm-hmm. So I'm going to have to have one thought in my head about economy too. It's going to be like a concert or something. I've prepared some things in advance. There's going to be a piece before the episodes and a piece after the episodes. And I'm going to try and find some documentary stuff to tweet images of during. I'm rather frantically looking around for that documentary stuff. But now I'm excited. I love the idea that this is a whole new form that Emily Cook's developed. And, you know, as always, going into a new form is brilliant.
Well, Paul, from all of us, thank you very much. Diolch yn fawr.